Hi all, welcome on Dave's Tech Channel, and in this video we will see that how we can install the MongoDB Community Edition on our Linux Debian system. So this is the official documentation page of the MongoDB installation. In the right side of the corner on this page you can see that we have multiple options to install the MongoDB. Right now we are installing the MongoDB on a Debian system, and it is the same for the installing the MongoDB on a Ubuntu system. We have other option also to install the MongoDB on a different kind of OS. So you can find the link of this documentation page on the description. Okay, so the process of installation on MongoDB on a Debian system, the first step is to import the public key. First copy this code of the public key import and open your terminal and paste this code on your terminal. After pasting the code, please hit the enter and provide your credential over there. After providing credential, hit OK. Now we have to go on a second step. Before we move on a second step, there is a note that if you get any kind of error, then you have to install the GNUPG. So if you get any kind of error, please first install this package and again hit the same first step. Okay, I will put the link of this documentation page on the description, so don't worry. Now let's move forward to the second step, and in the second step we have to create this thing, and we have to again copy the code. So it's nice that MongoDB provided all the thing, and we just have to copy the code and open a terminal again and paste the code on a terminal. So after pasting the code, hit the enter, and now let's move forward on a third step. Now we have to update the Ubuntu, and after updating Ubuntu, then this package will be added on a directory, and then we have to install the MongoDB package. This is the code which will install the MongoDB package on our Linux system. So again copy it and go on a terminal and paste it on a terminal. It will start the installation of the MongoDB. It will take time because the package is too heavy, so it will take time. Let me go on the documentation page again, and I will show you the other step you had to do after the installation will be successful. So here in a documentation you will find the step after you have to perform after the installation. Here, to start the MongoDB daemon, we have to hit this command on terminal. It will start the MongoDB daemon, then only you can host or launch the MongoDB on a local host. To find the status of the MongoDB daemon or to stop the MongoDB daemon, there is a command as well. So these are the necessary steps you have to perform after the installation to check the MongoDB is installed successfully or not. Here is the command called mongo, which will host or start the MongoDB on a local host. So first you have to start the MongoDB daemon, then to enter on the MongoDB CLI you have to run the mongo command. So here it will take some time. I will pause the video, then I will again come back. After the successful installation of the MongoDB, now we have to test it that the MongoDB is installed successfully or not. To test it, write the command sudo service mongod start. It will start the MongoDB daemon. If it will not give any error, which means the MongoDB is installed successfully. Now, what we have to do is we have to enter the mongo, okay? So the second step is to enter in the mongo, which will start the mongo CLI. So I will write the mongo and you will enter inside the mongo CLI. The basic command to find out that how many databases you have inside your MongoDB cluster is showDBS. It will show you that this many databases you have inside your MongoDB. So this three databases is automatically created when you install the MongoDB. So a Linux user is doing one thing extra, which is the start the MongoDB daemon explicitly by hitting the command sudo service mongod start. but the MongoDB daemon is automatically started on the Windows system at the time of boot. We already set up the thing in the last video when we installed the MongoDB on our Windows system. So that is the different, but rest of the thing will be the same, the MongoDB command and all those things. So let's meet on the next video where we will install the MongoDB Compass on our Windows system. Thank you all.